hope you are well and working hard to achieve your goals. So today we will start our next chapter, chapter 5, Sole Trader or Sole Proprietorship. The learning objectives of this chapter are to understand the meaning and definition of sole trade, characteristics of sole trade, evaluation of sole trade, its merits and demerits, suitability of sole proprietorship business, objectives of sole trade business, formation of sole trade business, is one man's control best in world, expansion of sole trade business, and then future of sole proprietorship business. So today we will discuss the meaning and definition of sole trade, characteristics of sole trade, and evaluation of sole trade, its merits and demerits. So first of all, we will discuss its key terms. So first is sole trading concern. For example, local chemist shop, small travel agency, local grocery shop, bakery shop or tailory. These are some examples of sole trading business. So we can say that sole trading business is any business which has only one owner, and the owner of such business is called sole trader. So our first topic is sole trade or sole proprietorship. So sole trade business is that type of business which is started and managed by one person, and one person is called sole proprietor. Sole means one and only, and proprietor means owner. So he is the only owner of his own business, and that person is responsible for its profits and losses. So this is the meaning of sole proprietorship business. So next is the characteristics of sole proprietorship business. So first one is individual proprietorship. So in such organization, the control of the business is in the hands of one person, and he is responsible for all the affairs of his business, and he has a responsibility for himself that how he start his business and work accordingly. So in this, he has an individual proprietorship. Next is sole management. As sole trader is the sole manager of business, so he is himself responsible for the functioning of his business. Next is unlimited liability. So the liability of the sole trader is unlimited. He is alone liable for all the risk and the activities of the business, and his personal property is also held liable. Next is freedom in selection of trade. So sole trader has a freedom to select any business of his choice, and he does not have to consult with any other person while selecting a business. Next is secrecy. So all important decisions are taken by the owner himself. So he keeps all business secrets to himself. Next is free from legal formalities. As there are no legal formalities of establishing and winding up of sole trade business, this type of business can be started as well as discontinued at any time without hurdles. So next characteristic is small size of business. So sole trader has a limited area of operation, and this is due to its limited resources. Limited resources like limited capital and limited management ability that he has. So that is why he cannot expand his business to a large scale. Next characteristic is sole ownership of capital. So in sole trade business, the capital is invested by a sole trader himself. If necessary, he can take loans. Otherwise, the capital is invested by the person who is the owner of that business. Next is personal relations. In sole trade business, sole trader is able to develop direct relationship with its customers. Like in a profession such as law or medicine, such direct relationships benefit the business. Next is the no separate entity. So legally, there is no difference between business and a businessman. So next characteristic is monopoly on profits. So in sole tradership business, sole trader bears all the risks of the business. So he is alone responsible for the profits and the losses of the business. Next is discretionary start and end. So in sole trade, the commencement or winding up is totally depends upon the sole trader's discretion. So he has a power to start and end his own business. So this is all about the characteristics. Next topic is evaluation of sole trade business, its merits and demerits. So first one, we will discuss the merits of sole trade business. So first merit is easy to start, as it is very easy to start this type of business organization because there are no legal formalities to start a business. So next one is prompt decisions. As sole trader is alone responsible for the business matters and he is not bound to consult any other person. So for taking a decisions, he can take decisions according to his own choice. Next is secrecy. So sole trader is the only owner and the manager of the business. So he is able to maintain secrecy because he can work according to his own choice. Next is personal relationships. So personal relations, sole trader is in a position to attract the customers by having a direct relationship with their customers. So he is able to judge the taste and demand of the customers. Next benefit is economy. So in a sole tradership business, production is done at small scale and he makes proper use of available resources so that he can reduce his cost of production. Next is easy to get loans. So he can easily get loans for the expansion of business because he is the only owner of his business and legally that can be recovered from his personal property, as personal property is held liable for recover loans. Next is incentive for hard work. So the more a sole trader works, the more benefits he gets out of that. Therefore, a sole trader works hard so that he can maximize his profits. Next is flexibility. So if there is a need for change in the business organization, then the sole trader is able to do so without any delay. So this is the term flexibility. Next is social benefits. So from the social point of view, sole tradership has major benefits. Like one is possibility of doing business with less capital and less risks, and ability to provide employment to other people also. Next is benefits of parental goodwill. So if a trader has got a business inheritance, then he is able to benefit himself with the goodwill of his parents. He learns business without any difficulty. Next is tax advantage. So from an income tax point of view, sole tradership business is the best because there is a less burden of tax on a sole trade business. Next point is ease of dissolution. So it is very easy to dissolve a sole tradership business because the dissolution decision is in the hands of business and there is no legal formalities regarding dissolution of business. So these are the merits of sole tradership business. Next is demerits. So first demerit is or disadvantage is limited capital. The sole trader is the one who provides capital. So the sole trader has a limited capital resources. He runs the business with his own money. So this is the disadvantage for sole tradership business. Next is limited managerial abilities. So in today's world, as market changes on a day-to-day basis, so sole trader being an individual cannot be perfect in handling all these issues and he cannot expand his business according to his own choice because he has a limited managerial ability. Next disadvantage is unlimited liability. So the liability of the sole trader is unlimited. So in case of high losses where the business assets are insufficient to pay the debts. His personal property can also be used for payment of losses or debts of the other persons. Next is instability. So this type of a business organization lacks stability because in case of emergencies like accidents, sickness or the death of the owner, the business comes to an end. Next are disadvantages, loss of quick decisions. As the sole trader is able to take a quick decisions, yet he has no one to consult. So therefore the decisions may go wrong and result in losses he can occur. Next is secrecy causes suspicion. So trader is able to keep the business secrets, but sometimes the secrecy becomes an obstacle in the way of development of the business. Next is weak bargaining position. So because of the limited area of operation, the sole trader has a weak bargaining power with its customer. Next are disadvantages, limited scope of expansion. Since the sole trader has a limited resources like management ability and capital, therefore he can expand his business up to a certain limit. Next are disadvantages, easy to replicate. As sole proprietorship being the most simplest business model can be easily replicated because it is easy to form and make more competition with the same products and services. So this is all about today's topic. So now you have to write the question answers. So first question is, what is sole proprietorship? Discuss its characteristics. And second question that you have to write the answer is, explain the merits and demerits of sole proprietorship business. So go through the various links and write the answers of these questions.